and welcome to this massive Good Friday game between South Adelaide and Glenelg. I'm Matt Rose. I'll be your host today, and I'm lucky enough to be joined by one of the big men from South Adelaide, Alex Cailotto. How are you going, mate?
Matt, very well. Thanks for having me. Big day of footy ahead.
Yeah, looking forward to it. Obviously, two informed sides coming in with two massive wins in round one, so it should be a good day of footy. Any predictions going into the day?
Yeah, as you said, both teams coming in hot. Glenelg, obviously, the reigning premiers, and South really unlucky not to win the flag last year. I'll probably go with South 1-13. What about yourself?
Yeah, I reckon it's going to be a close one, probably a low-scoring game. I can't see much more than 100 points being kicked between two teams, but I'll go to South by 6 points.
Just looking at the Glenelg players warming up, there's a few players in long sleeve, which is a little bit suspect for this time of year, so just maybe something about the mindset of those fellas.
Yeah, funny you bring up Glenelg. Do you actually know what Glenelg spelled backwards is?
No. You work at the primary school down there, don't you? Maybe you can fill us in.
Yeah, good. Cool, but it's actually Glenelg. So, yeah, just a little bit of trivia heading into the big day. But anyway, as we're in South Adelaide, you see a few solid boys. They've been in the gym. It's been a big...
That's what they're playing for. Have a go at it.
So maybe it is actually a grand final.
Could be a granny. Good Friday grand final. COVID has changed the landscape of the game.
Oh, there's the big fella going to the toss.
That's you. Rosey. Get in there, boys.
They put on a couple for him.
Jesus, is that in the strong room or what? Have a look at old Quadzilla Rose.
Big tits McGree. He's had a big summer. Oh, Tommy Woodall, see again. Oh, no, he's standing the mark this time. So that move that we said was a good move by Jared Wright. It's actually not paid off early with his opponent.
Touched on the line. Who's juked that?
Is that Brad Crabb?
He's back.
Crabb is back.
Good kick, straight to turnover. Yeah. That's what we like. Been working on that all summer.
That's probably safe to go. Tommy Highmore, the recruit.
Tommy Highmore. Mate, you can't get away with that stuff down here, mate. We're not in the NEFL anymore.
You do not chat. He hasn't spoken to Joey Haynes. Like, if you're playing fullback, you play on as much as you can.
That got you your state games, didn't it?
Yeah,
you know, nowhere before that new rule. Good Oz kick ruck style. Don't
here he is. Cailotto in the ruck. You did fill a few holes last year when you had to get the ruck. So.
Oh, boys, we're going forward. Would not like to be in the coach's box at the moment.
No.
Spitting chips.
Wouldn't want to be on the phone down in the box.
Nah. Oh, Blakely get his ear ripped off. Oh, good intercept mark.
Yeah, that's what he does, this bloke. Don't know much about him, but good to see. Good pace too. I think that was those
one
arms.
Thing we can't fault of the South Adelaide defenders, Rosey, is their aggressive intent on standing the mark. That's second and none, isn't it?
That's right. New grand final, that could be the difference. So I'd say that would be a
grand final. My old man always said to me, if you're playing grand finals on Good Fridays, it's how you stand the mark. That'll be the difference. Not the team that settles first.
Here's Malcolm Carpenter. No one's catching him if he gets it, but he's run completely past
he's
the ball.
He's got speed. One bounce. Two bounce. Go, son. Carpenter gets it back. Three bounce. To the goal square. Tits! No.
That's Nick Schwartz.
Nick Schwartz. Nicky Sal. Old jam tin Schwartz. That's a snag. Oh, and KO, first one to him.
That's great. Get to
that's him. Good. Colour less than solo boys sticking together. That's what we like. Quarter time. We're lucky.
So, what's your take on the first quarter, mate?
I think we're lucky to not be a lot more down than that. Well, yeah. What is the score?
Yeah. When we have a look at the stats here, you can see that two inside 50. So, to come away, how's the stats going? BMO hasn't touched it from what I just quickly saw briefly there, so we're going to need a lift from him. And
let's see what the second quarter brings.
Oh, BMO, he tackles though. He doesn't need possessions.
Is that another 50?
Oh, another 50. Is that against Haynes?
I'll tell you what.
He is a bit of a fiery redhead.
Oh, this isn't pretty, is it? I don't want to call it early. I know it's only second quarter, but I reckon it might be Mouthguards Mondays, boys. This looks a bit more like it, a little bit more direct. Oh,
yeah,
and a juke. Who's that?
See, that's what happens when you get it in quick to Darnell Tucker. You know he's good one-on-one in the body. So, get it
plays
in deep
his best footy on Good Fridays.
There it is.
You little beauty.
Cailotto, once again, you just love. You're
that's
always
what I'm about.
For the half-off.
Haven't had a kick, but I'm first to everybody who kicks a goal.
That's what it's about. Yep.
Oh, and in the ruck, rewarded for his good teammanship. One thing we haven't addressed, Matt, is being a good Friday grand final. What do you reckon the boys' pre-game meal was? Obviously, red meat's off the card. A few tuna subs.
Yeah, well, that's what's going to come down. Without the meat, are they going to have enough, I suppose, nutrients to get through the game?
Yeah.
So
your regular halftime meals will be out the window. A few Cailotto fishes, maybe.
What are some of the superstitions of the boys? Do we know any? I know Krabby always used to wear his same jocks.
Yeah, he wore the same
about
jocks.
About 2002.
What did he used to drink? Tonic water? That was a bit weird.
Yeah, you're always having a little nap just before the game.
A little nap. Crossy's got lots of superstitions, doesn't he? He's got a lot.
Yeah, he bumps the wall. Yeah, he bumps the wall a bit.
Bumps the wall, and he does that weird chant to himself before he runs out.
He's fighting a hurry again. He's actually been good. The difference here.
Spedro. Little plug for Nexus Sport. Good athlete development centre in the western suburbs.
It is a little bit of a mini fight back from South going into the half.
Oh, good little intercept. Baz. Joey Haynes.
Here we are.
The biggest barrel chest in the southern hemisphere. Here he goes.
You saw Broadbent trying to get received.
To quote the great Dalton Tucker.
Who's that? Sam Overall. Remember, he actually...
The old bowleg overall.
2013, he had a huge impact against the Eagles on this oval, so he knows the oval like the back of his hand. Inside 50s low, disposals low. I think the big one, if you look at it there, is the tackle rate. Just they're almost 2-1, and if you're going to win a grand final, as Timmy Jinnaba used to say to me, you just got to lay tackles, you just got to hunt. Cam McGree has been best on from line.
We might be taking Sir Jack Odie home. Snag?
Yeah.
Yes.
Joel Cross watching this replay would be so proud. He always says Cam was his boy.
Oh, that's a nice little clean take out the middle. Was that Darnell?
That's Malcolm Carpenter.
Ali.
Soccer. They've done it. This is the start they wanted.
Bang,
Shaker Wilkinson. Shaker Wilkinson.
Shake. He's got a bit of mongrel in him. Good heels, boy. Rosie's been flung in the ruck.
That's not a bad call.
That's pretty ordinary footy.
Shorter switch kick to nothing. This summer. They're very hot on hold the ball, although they haven't played it there. It's hard to hear over the crowd. There's got to be at least 45,000 here, Alex.
A good crowd. Being a good Friday grand final, there's nothing else open. Could make celebrations a little bit hard for either team, but yeah, it's good to see people in there.
Matt Rose in the ruck
Rose,
again.
Rose, you've been instrumental in the ruck. Look at that. Hit the space. Bounce.
Bimo, get rid of it, son.
No awareness. You know what? Big gripe on that. Where's the talk? It's not Bimo's fault. Where's the talk? You would have thought by now, after the 11th kick to the same spot, Glenelg might have cottoned on and just put a man in the back pocket, but no, sticking to their guns of the zone.
Good smother, though. It's how you follow it up for mine.
That's aggressive.
Everyone makes mistakes. It's just don't make the same mistake.
And he gets his reward. As the great Buddha Hocking said, you'll get your lick of the ice cream. And then he's been mowed down.
Shout out to Butcher. Oh, Butcher. Actually, Buddha, who I'm sure is watching this.
Buddha will be tuning in. He'll be all over this.
Be a bit better on Good Friday.
Yeah. Good Whaler boy, Benny Sawford. Old man used to own the steel factory down there.
Beautiful spot, Whaler. Here's Fitty. We called for him.
Here he is, the big ball. He's a very heavy set for a young lad, isn't he?
Oh, massive. He's kicked on his right foot. Last I remember, he was a lefty, but...
It's a good intercept, Mark.
Oh, Reece Nilsson. He'll sit under him all day, all day. Where is he? Oh, we keep forgetting this is Sawford's old team, so if anyone's going to know how to beat him... Oh, he's missed the ball.
Good intel. Have a look at the pipes on you. Unbelievable. A little bit of Brady Sackle on the head as well. Which isn't a compliment, FYI. Look at that, asserting authority. This is business. All right, up by a point.
All right.
Accurate kicking, keeping us in it at the moment. You can see Glenelg have had 16 scoring shots to South Adelaide 7. Run us through the stats, Hose.
The Clangers is the one that stands out. 38 to South. You can see Tommy Highmore's jumped to the top of the possession board. The effectiveness of them is to be questioned. I've liked Joey Haynes, but Cam McGree's been the big one for me. So a few boys for a lift this quarter. I'd love to see Benny Sorford get a bit more involved.
First ever Good Friday Grand Final, 1 point in it. Couldn't have scripted that if we tried.
Sorford, you called for him, and he responds.
Here we go. Here we go. The boy from Wyala.
There it is.
Straight
get to
through.
Him, boys. Get to him.
There we go. The old umpire.
First again.
How big's your fish? He'll kick from 50.
And they haven't really been carrying today, have they?
Our commentator's curse. Let's carry the full journey and then some. Cam McGree again. He's been instrumental. Without him, I'm saying South Adelaide on this game. There you go. Look at that. The other ruckman's running away. Petrified of him. Glenelg still gets the hit out, though, don't they?
Take it out the ruck. He hasn't, has he?
Oh, it's going through. Kidding me.
This is going to take something special. 5-point ball game.
I've got McGree back in the ruck. Smart.
Defenders, who's that? Oh.
Right, we can make something out of this. Inside
straight,
50.
Man.
Intercept mark. Jeez, Glenelg have been resolute down there, haven't they? I can't see the score, so you have to bring that up. If
yeah, so
close here.
43-48. So we've got a 5-point ball game. Not high scoring, as I believe one of the commentators predicted before
Let's
the
go.
Game. But we have Wilkinson. Made his debut last
Little
year.
Little shaker Wilkinson. Right.
Twilight Grand Final, he's kicked it, and doesn't he love it?
Good Friday Grand Final.
There can't be long left. There cannot be long.
The boys are flagging a bit now.
Quick snap.
It's really how much you want, isn't it? No, he's everywhere.
Off the bench.
That's a goal. Oh, he's hit it.
Has he kicked it?
He's hit the post.
Oh.
Hainsy, surely we go long here. We've kicked short all day. And we kick short again. Let's just get some yardage. We've played on.
He's playing too safe. It's all tied up. We can't hope for a result. You've got to create one. Oh, that's a risky switch. Is that McGree? That's huge. Quickly down. Tucker.
Look at that.
In front. Hit the crumb.
Man.
Is that Wilkinson again? Sorford against his old team. He's kicked it.
The boy from Wyala.
Get to him. They'd be watching.
Couldn't be long left.
Yeah, but I'm loving the replays. He'd be loving the replays.
You little beauty.
They've done it.
Unbelievable. Look at the boys. They're wrapped. Absolutely wrapped.
Against the reigning premiers to come out and do that.
Well, that's right. 1964, last ever premiership. First ever Good Friday Grand Final, and South have won it. Makes sense, really, doesn't it? You would be down there, hand on the cup, no doubt about it. Who else would want to be down there, I reckon?
I'd probably say...
Fitty?
You'd probably have your Liam Fitt. Yeah, Fitty.
Liam Fitt of the world. I reckon Shake it a little circle out.
Joey Haynes. Tom Mymore. Malcolm Carpenter had a good game. Real impact game. Benny Sorper kicking two, and Shaker Wilkinson as well. But I thought best on was, yeah, I would have said Cam McGree was best.
Cam McGree, unbelievable scenes. Crowd favourite, Cam McGree.
Matt Rose was on four at quarter time and didn't register another one. Didn't know if he was Buddy Arthur or Martha after quarter time. But,
to be fair, he ran in the ruck for a bit. Not an easy spot to play.
Yeah.
Make sure you're ruckman.
But everyone's contributed. They'll walk off the ground knowing everyone contributed.
Pretty special day for South Adelaide, I reckon, Rosie. I reckon that's about it for us. We're going to jump on the first Uber up Cement Hill and get down to Jimmy Dean's for a cold, will be your beverage of choice tonight, Rosie. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Rosie, thanks for having me on the commentary team.
As always, mate, it's been my absolute privilege and just fantastic to see South end the drought. All their fans, good to see them at the game, and I'm sure we're looking forward to more success in the coming year. I was made for this.